यस बेटा, लेट्स रिवाइज नेक्स्ट चैप्टर. योर विजन टेस्ट वन इज बेस्ड ऑन फर्स्ट फ्लाइट ऑल चैप्टर, सो वी आर डूइंग फर्स्ट फ्लाइट पहले. ठीक है, टू स्टोरीज अबाउट फ्लाइंग नेक्स्ट चैप्टर वी आर गोइंग टू रिवाइज. पार्ट वन हिज फर्स्ट फ्लाइट. And name of the chapter is two stories about flying. We all know, fine. Part one we are going to start today. So you write down. It is a story of hesitation, trial, error, and being succeeded. First value point is that it is a story of hesitation. Firstly, we hesitate to do something. Then trial, we give it a try. Then we commit mistakes, errors. And then finally, we get success. Clear? So very first line is, the theme of the story is, this is the story of hesitation, trial, error, and success. So the word which they have used, fine, as to give this theme or present this theme is a seagull. Fine. So protagonist of the chapter is here a seagull. Mostly the birds which are found near the sea area. So a seagull is there. A young seagull is there. Fine. She is very hesitant of flying. Fine. Being young one, she has not started flying yet, and she very hesitates. But parents, they want that the way they want their children to learn to fly. So in that way, she gives it a shaky start also. Seagull's story. Fine. So this is Seagull's story. Shaky start. Shaky start of flying. Or you can say seagull is afraid of flying. Fine. All the points, then I'll just explain. Parents perfecting brother and sister. Parents, they took the charge that they will be teaching to all the children, but young seagull is afraid. I'm just observing those who are very casual. Brother or sister. Brother and sister are also called sibling of seagull. Fine. Parents, they perfecting siblings of seagull or brother and sister of seagull. Fine. And every parent wants that, each and every parent, they wish that all the children, they become successful in lives. They never think that one child is successful, the other, okay, let it be. No, they want equal achievements for both. Fine. In one or the other way. So then after that, when they try to perfect the seagull, then finally maddened by hunger, mother does not offer food to it. So a mother is never, you know, your enemy. She always thinks for the best of her child. So in this case, seagull's mother, she decides not to feed fish or any other thing to this seagull, so that it tries to show that they are enjoying their food altogether. But then this seagull got maddened by hunger. It dived at the fish, which was his favorite food. Dived, jumped at the fish, at the sight of fish. So mother pretends, she acts as if she's going to feed him, but she does not feed him at all. Fine, she just pretends that she was catching a fish in its mouth and she starts flying towards it. And the seagull thought that my mother is going to feed me. But actually she stops on the way and this seagull got maddened by hunger and dived at the fish. So finally, when we, you know, after facing the fear, so this is the first time facing the fear by seagull. It starts fluttering its wings. Obviously, it is a natural phenomena of the bird that definitely when it jumps and dives from a height, it's a natural thing that it will flutter the wings, facing the fear by a seagull. And finally, last point I'm speaking, but you can ask me. Okay? So facing the fear by a seagull. And finally, first flight was taken. Finally, फर्स्ट फ्लाइट जो पहली उड़ान थी उसकी राइट फर्स्ट फ्लाइट वॉज टेकन बाय सीगल दिस इज द वे इट लर्न टू फ्लाई बाय ट्रायल एंड एरर मेथड ट्राई किया गलतियां हुई दोबारा ट्राई किया सो दिस चैप्टर दीज आर द वैल्यू पॉइंट सो द वेरी फर्स्ट लाइन इज द थीम ऑफ द स्टोरी That this is the story of hesitation, trial, error, and success. You cannot be successful in life unless and until you try. Just sitting at a place and just imagining the things to happen, you will not. Find you have to learn to drive a car, you have to learn it. Then you will try, you will practice, and finally you will be perfect in it. Similarly, in any skill of our lives, we have to learn it, we have to practice it, and we will be successful. Without practice, we cannot succeed. So this is the example of seagull's story, first flight. Fine. So young seagull was sitting alone on the ledge, fine. And his two brothers and sisters, they already had learned the art of flying. Each and every individual, you see, open your hands like this, fine. You see, all fingers are different. Though one hand, uniformity is not there. And similarly, your brother and sister, though you are born to one parent, but you are not alike. Your preference will be different. Your sister's preference will be different. She can be intelligent in one subject. You can be intelligent in the other. Fine. So it is vice versa. Everybody has individual persona. You cannot compare and contrast with others. But maybe they were quick learners. Fine. So that's why brother and sister, both they learned to fly. Fine. He thought that, you know, his wings won't support him. So this is all in our mind only. So this young seagull, see, she had preconceived notions. Ye bhi theme ho sakta hai is chapter ka. Never ever have preconceived notions or ideas. Pehle apne mind ko fill mat kar do. Some children, they start thinking that I'm very bad at maths and when exam will come, paper will come, I'm going to fail. Definitely you will fail then. Fine. If you have such kind of thinking in any subject, not math, social science, whatever you are scared of. So firstly, you have to make up your mind that no, if this person can do, why can't I? Fine. You have to practice only. You have to give that particular subject more time as compared to other subjects. And then after practicing, definitely you don't need anyone's help to cheat even. You just practice harder and then at least you can get passing marks, but that will be your own marks, not anybody else's. So this seagull had notion in the mind that its wings will not support it. Pehle soch liya ki main nahi ud sakta hu and because my wings are not going to support me. So his parents, brother, sister, they regularly taunted him. Fine, that you are a coward, their poke. For its cowardice, he kept on getting taunts. Then finally, mother decides everybody was having, you know, great time. They were jumping, eating, flying, merrymaking. And finally, when they were sleeping, this young seagull was fond of eating fish. So mother knows this. You know, jaise hum kya karte hain, chote bachche se koi kaam karwana, what do we offer? chocolates, candies, and that child will be very happy to do your work then. Otherwise, they never listen to you. So, maddened by hunger, he dived at the fish, and with a loud scream, he fell outwards in the space, into the whole space. And he did not even realize that he started flying. Fine, firstly, when he tried to fly, he was seized with terror. He was terrorized, gripped with a feeling of fear. But when his wings were cutting through the air, he was not falling on the ground. Then he completely forgot that he never flown ago. He kabhi usne pehle kiya hi nahi fly. And finally, he was floating on the sea. His family came to praise him, applaud for him, encourage him. Then everybody started offering him piece of fish. You know, human psychology hai that you should give a feedback to a child. Let me tell you theory of behavior. How your behavior is formed. Yes, beta, sit straight. How the theory of behavior is formed? Feedback, positive and negative, both are required. You have done something wrong, extremely wrong. Aur lekin aapko kuch bhi nahi kaha jaye. There is tendency to repeat that act again. Fine. So if you will get negative feedback, punishment, that is negative feedback, but it works. But punishment should not be to, you know, that level ki aapko koi hurt ho jaye. But yes, aisi honi chahiye that you should learn a lesson that I am not going to repeat it in the future. Agar ye nahi hoega, to tendency to repeat hoegi, wo repeat ho ki aapki habit ban jayegi. Fine. And if you have done something good, positive feedback is required. Kyun? So that next time you perform better. If I will not say, okay, very good, well done, aapke notebooks pe kuch bhi na mile, you say na, you feel na, ma'am, maine sara kaam kiya. Mujhe koi comment hi nahi mila wahan pe, koi compliment hi nahi mila. Fine, if I write, complete your work, a red pen, a teacher has marked, how bad you start feeling. Aap kehte ho itna kaam kiya, wo to dekha nahi hai, ek question choda tha, ma'am has written like that only. So why we write? Because so that next time you make sure ki I'll be sending complete work. And I definitely try to give as many goods and very goods and excellent and well done to all the students, those who have completed and submitted notebooks well in time. So that encourages us. We all are like that only. So encouragement is required. That is also one theme of the chapter, that one should encourage others. Our family is always there for our welfare. Hamari family hamara bura nahi sochegi. If they are scolding us, our parents are taunting us, that is for our benefit. Fine. So young seagull was very timid in the beginning and very brave and courageous at the end of the chapter. Clear? So let's do the second part. The black aeroplane. Write down. Fine, write down. Second part is black aeroplane. Part two, we are going to start. Okay, let me ask some MCQs first and then I'll continue. I'll be sharing screen, beta. You please note down the questions at least, if not all the options. Yes, beta, screen is visible. Who is the author of His First Flight? We never pay attention to it, na? Who is the author of His First Flight? Lamo Faray, Roald Dahl, Paulo Coelho, Frederick Forsyth. Frederick Forsyth is the author. Because humne padha nahi, isliye I'm giving you answer. But you should know at least. Isme aapko spelling learn karne ki zarurat nahi hai author ke name mein. obviously fine, but you should know the name at least because you're going to choose it. So be a smart worker. You have to go through all the names of poets, all the names of authors, as well as chapters. आपको ये भी पता होना चाहिए कि चैप्टर का नेम हिज फर्स्ट फ्लाइट है कि द फर्स्ट फ्लाइट है या ओनली फर्स्ट फ्लाइट है. क्लियर? तो यू शुड नो हु इज द ऑथर ऑफ ब्लैक एरोप्लेन. दैट विल बी अगेन अ नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, बट ऑथर इज सेम ओनली. क्लियर? द लेसन फर्स्ट फ्लाइट इज अबाउट अ पैरेट, अ सीगल, अ पीजन और पायलट. दिस इज वेरी इजी. व्हाई वाज सीगल अफ्रेड टू फ्लाई? ऑप्शन ए, ही वॉज अ कॉवर्ड. Option B, he was afraid his wings will not support him. Option C, he was afraid that everyone would judge him. Option D, both one and two. He was a coward. He was afraid his wings won't support him. Others would call him a coward. Fine. What did his parents threaten him with? What did I repeat? What did his parents threaten him with if he did not flew away? They asked him to never talk to him, to punish him, to starve him, to abandon him. Yes, fine. They decided that they won't feed him. Starvation. Woo. What were his parents teaching his brothers and sisters? To skim the waves, to dive for fish, to perfect the art of flying, all of the above. She said something else, yes? To dive for fish, yes, or? All of the above is the correct answer. They were telling how to dive for fish, skimming the waves and perfecting the art of flying. So all of the above is the correct answer. The sight of Dash maddened him. Options are his brothers flying, his siblings enjoying, food, all of the above. Yahan pe food answer hai because they have not mentioned fish. What urged him to make his first flight? Very confusing this is. Very confusing. The answer sunna. What urged him to make his first flight? Hunger, sight of fish, courage, both one and two. Sight of fish. Both one and two. He was hungry as well as sight of fish. Why did mother stop midway while giving him the fish? Why did she stop midway? Option A, she was mad at him. Option B, to push him to fly out of hunger. Option C, she did not want to give him the fish. Option D, she got tired. To push him to fly hunger. Fine, so now that's it for this chapter. Let's move on to the black aeroplane. So Frederick Forsyth is the author of this also. The both parts are written by one author, you remember, okay? Rian, you're very, very casual today. I don't know why. Why are you concentrating upon him? You're preparing for your exams. Don't concern. No, I'm just not. So, clear theme of this story is quite different. No, you can sit there, but just mind your ways. In this story, the black aeroplane, firstly, we just finds the narrator. So write down first point. It will be clear to you. Write down, beta. The black aeroplane. First point, narrator on his way to England. You should know where he was flying to. He was flying to England. Narrator was on his way to England. Everybody, beta, I'll be seeing your notebooks. Those who are at home, please note down. Right, narrator was on his way to England. So he was flying old Dakota aeroplane. Dakota, you should know the name. D-A-K-O-T-A. Fine. So a narrator, clear sky it was. Clear. There was not a single cloud. Fine. Moon was shining. Narrator was flying his old Dakota aeroplane over France back to England. So his flight is from France to England. Ye yaad rakhna hai aapko. Then he contacted Paris control for instructions. Remember this also. Whom he contacted? Paris control. Value points note karte jao. Fine. He contacted Paris control for instructions. Then he was asked to turn 12 degrees west. Kya instructions aayi usko? Take a turn 12 degrees west. They have a compasses and all, na? So they kept on getting instructions accordingly. They take turns. And you know, he thought that he would be in time for English breakfast. According to him, he will reach well in time at the time of breakfast and he will enjoy his breakfast with his family. That was his estimation. Clear? Second point, likho. Clouds started hovering. Clouds started hovering. H-O-V-E. Lingering means. Fine, cover over. Clouds started hovering, comma, stormy weather. Suddenly stormy weather. Ye hint ke liye aapko bhi yaad rahe story. Suddenly stormy weather. S-T-O-R-M-Y. Stormy weather. Yes, beta. Weather, W-E-A-T-H-E-R. So, you know, what happened when he was going from Paris to England? He was 150 kilometers behind him. Paris was 150 kilometers behind him. Fine. So 150 kilometers means wo aage aa chuke hai. You should know the fact. So he saw that there are sudden clouds hovering in the sky. They were not the simple clouds. They were stormy clouds. Weather was quite stormy. Fine. And they looked like black mountains standing in front of him. So black clouds were there actually. That his vision was blocked. Fine. He could not avoid by flying up and over them. He did not have enough petrol or fuel. One and same thing. So he was thinking that I do not have proper fuel to fly around them north and south. So he thought, he had one thought that I should go back to Paris. Itna weather kharab hai, I'm not having the vision. So I should fly back to Paris. But in front of him, he was missing his family and he wanted to have a good breakfast, England breakfast, English breakfast with his family. Fine. Next point, likhiye. All the instruments were dead. All the instruments were dead. Yeah, stopped working, you can say. Now just listen. So narrator, he took the risk. You know, there were two choices in front of him. What choice? First choice was he thought that I should go and fly back to Paris. Abhi main 150 kilometer aage aaya hu, I will fly back. It will at least save my life. But then he thought ki maybe I can pass on through these stormy clouds. Maybe they are sometimes, you know, weather is unpredictable. Nature is very unpredictable. Sometimes you see, na, there in your school here, it is raining. When you reach back home, it was not raining there. So in that way, he thought that maybe there was a chunk of clouds I can pass easily. So narrator took the risk. Fine. He flew the old Dakota straight into the storm. He took that risk of flying the plane into the stormy weather. And inside the clouds, everything suddenly became black. He did not have any vision. Earlier it was fainted, but now it was all black vision. Fine. He could not see anything outside. His aeroplane started twisting and jumping and turning. And every instrument, he started looking for the compass, because compass tells about the directions. It stopped working. The other instruments were suddenly dead too. He tried to contact through the radio to the Paris control, but there was no answer because sara kuch instruments toot chuke. He was not able to contact them. Fine. Next is, suddenly black plane emerged. emerged means suddenly aaya wo kahin se. Suddenly a black plane emerged to help him. Suddenly a black plane emerged to help him. So he was lost in the storm. He was not finding the path. Suddenly he saw that there was another aeroplane, and that black aeroplane was flying next to him. That next that he could see the pilot's face also. He was glad to see another person. And what that another pilot says to him, follow me. Fine. Have you ever imagined that two pilots are talking to one another? Fine. So another pilot asked him to follow me. And he said, waving his one of the hands. Narrator followed him like an obedient child because he did not have compass. He did not have any direction. He did not have radio control. He decided, let me follow this man only, whatever he says. Fine. And he landed safely at England. And when he reaches, he went to the control room. He gets to know that there was no any aeroplane flying that day. So that was quite surprising. We'll continue tomorrow, bitte.